Welcome back, Any Lovers. Today we're checking out Wantless. Look at and grab yourself a plate. This is part of the tabletop sale that's going on Steam right now. So I was like, I really kind of want to check out some of these games, but surprisingly, a lot of them we've already checked out. So I saw this one in the corner and I was like, hey, we should check this one out though. So we're going to hop in here, check out the game for a little while. As you see, that gives you a pre-early alpha warning, which means it's very early in development. So you're probably not going to get your hands on this anytime soon. But it's still nice to have this on your wish list, which is a great thing, by the way. Wish lists are amazing. You should be wishlisting everything that you like because, as you see right down here, it does help. It really does. This is why developers push it so crazy, and this is why it's something that's so pushed hardcore in this channel. So, let's go check it out. Go into the save slot here, number one. Wantless has a few unusual mechanics and still lacks feedback clarity in its current development stage, so we recommend playing through the tutorial first. Take about 10 minutes. Let's do the tutorial. Has unusual things. I like unusual things. I don't think it's sad. We used to have to deal with frustration and needs. Now we can choose. What between frustration and needs? Needs. Sleepers made their choice. Now they're fulfilled. I don't think it's sad. But there's always a but. Maybe I'll stick around just a little longer. Try not to lose track of effects affecting yourself or your enemies. What that means? Chan transpose Yun into slumber. And you're in. Boy is fast asleep up here. Does he look more cheerful on this side? Nope, not exactly bearing either. Then again, he wouldn't ask to have his whole conscience removed if he was. Fair enough. Been a while. Are your feelings okay? I had to readjust my chair. I think so, but I could use your help remembering. Okay, boy. Peace is on its way. Left click on a tile to move. Moving is free when out of combat. You can also move the camera. You could also move the camera using the direction arrows and adjust the zoom level using the mouse wheel. What happens if I don't have arrows? When you're ready, reach the exit tile and press F. Can I just like zoom around a little bit? To enter the next room. Cool. Ooh. Wretch. Thoughts long abandoned, forgotten. Not out of shame or growth, merely for the lack of relevance. High damage melee. And mobile. Your turn. Wretches, abandoned thoughts. I haven't missed these. I have to spend action points to move and cast in combat. Let's just walk up to the one straight ahead and auto attack it. Okay. Your action points displayed here. You start every turn with 8. Move a tile costs 1. Casting skills cost anywhere between 1 and 8. However, hover over your skills, get information for each one. You can use them by clicking the icons and use a 1 through 9 shortcuts. Okay, let's go up here. Let's see, 1 is a auto attack, AP costs 2, deals 30 to 40, which would be nice, or telekinesis, pushes the target away up to 5, heal, or deals 7 to 80 pain damage. Thunderclap! Spending all your AP isn't always the best move. Ending your turn early is key to keeping your enemies from doing too much harm. Press space or click end turn. Yeah, but why wouldn't I want to, like... Okay, I guess, like, keep him out of range here. You guys broken subconscious turn now, and you gave it a lot of work with. I know. They get as many action points as I've spent for their turn. Oh! That was fair, Spareless. You are rusty. No point in healing now. Just finish them off. Ow. Ow! Hovering an enemy with the cursor will fade in its health and action points widget. It is important to keep track of how many AP each enemy currently has. If an enemy has leftover AP it cannot use during its turn, it will stockpile and save these points for next turn. Stockpile AP shows in blue color. Oh, it has 2. Okay, well, I have 2 AP costs to heal myself. And then I have 2 AP costs to punch his face in. Aha! Choose a neural pulse. Restore up to 50% of your max HP and cleanse negative effects. Okay. Is it like a move? Is there anything in the room that I really need to clear? That's a cool looking thing. Where's the exit? Oh. They can't move around. I don't have arrow pads. I have one of those mini keyboards. I don't have the arrow keys. Honestly, I have a big keyboard down below me. I just need to install it. I got it on sale. I got a Razer keyboard on sale. It was really cheap. $20, I think it was. An impulse, explosive by nature. Try to push it right into the pack of wretches. Use telekinesis. Telekinesis as in the skill in your second slot. Be careful not to explode that thing in your face. Oh, this thing? Killing an enemy restores one action point. Pushing the impulse into the pack of wretches should give you enough to reach the isolated one on the left. Aha! You dead. I love it. That was cool. Gain a shield. Effects, negative or positive, are a major part of combat. Hover over lists the list of effects currently affecting and hold Alt while hovering over for more details. Shielded for 300. Ooh, you should always be aware of effects affecting your characters. Yeah, they said that in the pre-patch name notes, you know. Wait, why is it going over all the things? Spending all your AP isn't always the best end. Yeah, see, it's going through all the things again. Why? Why? Why is it going through all the things again? Okay, we gotta find the exit. This is the exit right here, right? I read that as acne. Sorry. What's that thing? Oh, it's a dog. Is that a good memory? Rot. Toxic thoughts hidden rather than dealt with. They're still there, silently rotten, growing. Terrain soiling explodes on death, poison. Ooh. That's not good. There's a memory. I should preserve the valuable information inside. Careful not to break it. Urine's mind wouldn't like that. This guy I could deal with. Right? I kind of want to get out of the way now. I stockpiled. Cool. I'm okay with that. See, I kind of want to get out of the way. How much HP do you have? Ow! He hurt. Gain damage up to 6 turns. Let's do that so I don't get any negative effects. Wait. Sometimes rots burst on death, dealing trying to destroy them. Wait, did I miss the memory though? Was I supposed to pick up that memory? Oh no. Oh, I think I was supposed to pick up the memory while I could have hit this thing. That's what was going on. I was supposed to set myself up for that one, probably. Oh. Hello. Forgotten ego. Though the self feels continuous across time, you weren't always who you are today. You used to be another person and another even before that, even with their own perspective, hopes, and dreams. These other selves came and went. You matured and then they disappeared. Or did they? Protects, allies, and it's pushy. So does it push me? The core of Urine's woes. He's consciousness. You know what to do. Kick his butt. Explodes, dealing fear damage. Ooh. When a memory is lost, transportation grows unstable. Instability enhances enemies and unpredictably alters combat layout. Preserve memories to stabilize the patient. Oh no! It set me up! The game set me up. Oh, wow. I still got shield, so I'm like, whatever. Weight of the past? Wait, whoa. What the hell's going on over here? Oh my gosh. Oh, it killed itself. Exactly what I wanted to do. Planned. Or was it planned? It was planned. Totally planned. It was totally not planned. Choose three. Common form synopsis, tier one, heals 2 and 30, or dual. There. Experience level one. Oh, okay. Those were chosen already. Okay. Did I get an experience? Capture memory is zero. Oh, no, I didn't capture anything. Dump's dead. Listen, I thought that I was capturing it by defeating the enemies, so the enemies didn't destroy him. So this way, he was. I don't know. This choice determines your starting skills and talent tree perks, so you're immediately ready for action and won't lock you out from freely customizing your build. Focus on melee combat-oriented skills for those who enjoy taking the therapy up close. Mixes range combat and movement-oriented skills for those who enjoy efficiency and control. Mixes damage over time and utility skills for those who enjoy planning ahead and challenging their spirit. I kind of like that. Push the target away up to 5 tiles. Think for dealing pure damage every time the target takes damage for 3 turns. Inflicts poison. Ooh, push the target back away 5 tiles. Decreases damage over time. Let's choose the poison one because I'm a poison. Biatch. Plum. Morning, Arius. Ready to get back in the lab? Morning. Are we expecting any patients today? You mean beyond the people already waiting? It's been a while since a transposer last operated these parts. Words was quick to spread. Join me in the Neural Forge to craft a little something, then we'll work. Then to work, mastermind. Day 2. A new day has dawned. Events? None. Oh, cool. What's this place? Oh, look. People staying outside. Here you are, Rusty. Since you've been off the job for a while, I'll try to jog your memory real quick. The Neural Forge is part of the transposer's base toolkit. The device lets you turn special data components into new skills you can use to transpose in. You can call those data components synapses, and you'll need at least 3 of them to create a skill, one for each type. Form synapses to determine skills, area effect, range, and the amount of effects it can apply. Oh! Effect synapses determine what the skill does to whatever it hits, and efficiency synapses determine the skill's cost and action points and its cooldown. Synapses aren't consumed on craft, but they can't be used to compose more than one skill at the same time. Try and craft a simple healing spell when unused synapses now. Okay. Here's your new drag and drop matching synapses types to the crafting skills to produce results. Equipping a skill reserves discipline from your pool. Stronger skills have a higher discipline cost. You can change your skill's icon or name and click on it when you're happy. Validate. Cool. So drag that. Effect is going to be healing. Efficiency. Oh, so I could technically get 2 of these and like double heal, right? Forge it. Access the gear menu to equip crafted skills. Okay. Gear. Okay, time to equip your craft. You might have noticed it in the forge, your skill has a discipline cost. Whenever it's equipped, it temporarily reserves that amount from your available discipline. Aside from your auto attack, everything can be swapped in and out. You should have enough spare discipline to equip that new healing craft. Try and drag it into that empty slot. Don't I have a healing? I guess I don't have a healing, do I? There we go. You can now open patient's menu to get back to transposing. To equip a skill, dragons aim. I did that already. Thank you. Brings you back to life with 25% HP. I have 10 of those. Simple gloves. Mantle. And I have these 4 things. That's super cool. Bye, tree. Welcome to the vine tree. Unlock experiences to power up and specialize your build. Whenever you're done learning, confirm your changes and apply them. Available fleeting experience. I have no learning points though, because I suck. Okay. Patience. Check your gear and setup, then go ahead and choose your next patient. Remember to watch their mind's gate, their mind mazes, tier, length, and rewards before you make your choice. It'll be there to connect you when you're ready, and don't go greedy on levels you're not as good as you used to be. Okay. Addicted man, desolate. Oh, these are all cool. Ooh, spite gloves. I want spike gloves, I think I want spike gloves. So do I have to get all of their memories? That's what's going on? Or I don't get paid? Keep it in! This is the commitment gauge. It fills every time you choose the hardest available room the way of the resolute. Filling the gauge yields knowledgeable shards and other special bonuses. Hover the gauge to see what other rewards it yields. Plus one item reward choice at the end, doubled reputation earnings, halved reputation loss. Plus one reward choice at the end, double currency and XPs. Let's do it. Holy crap. Okay. Obsession pod. Thoughts aren't usually born forsaken or toxic, but some parts of you have developed a habit of spitting only the most worthless of seeds. Spawns allies. Oh, I gotta get rid of that quick. Is this a kick still? Perfect. Oh god, I forgot he did that. Taint? Ew. Ow, ow. Crap. You earned awareness point. Awareness is earned by destroying enemies and landing and lets you use powerful skills or resurrect in combat. Oh, cool. Alright, so let's do this. Let's heal. Let's move once. And then let's do this. That's a push, right? Okay, let's impale fracture. And then let's push them away. And just like that. And he's dead. Yeah! Obtain random gloves. Ooh. Way of the Resolute. Commitment gauge has increased. Nice. So this is the hard way, and this is the normal way. Inventory. Gain random gloves. Spike gloves. Can I not equip those right now? No, I want to equip them. Dang it. Okay, whatever. Let's go for the hard way again. That was fun. Another memory. Memory. What are these? I saw the Fallsless shell of an ancient nightmare is empty now. It should be empty now. Oh god. Some enemies hold patient memories captive. They're marked with a memory warden. Destroy them before combat ends to release the memory and get a chance to preserve it. Let's go there. And we'll blow them up. Ow. How do you have so much movement? Just saying. I wish he would have flew right there, because I would have been monster. Oh, this thing's brooding. I gotta get over there real fast. Okay. Push target 5 weight, decrease damage resistance. Okay. You're a wretch, you're a wretch. So I'll just punch and punch, basically. Punch. Bye. Punch. Bye. Thank you. I can't heal right now. I don't want Thunderclap there because I want to destroy this. So I can't Thunderclap there. As much as I'd like to. Boom. He's going to launch, isn't he? Ah, I knew it. Thank you. I need that. Was that another memory? Oh, shit. That's another memory right there. Crap. A hole. There's that. Let's heal. Heal's awesome. Damn, dude. If I was... How much AP do I got? I got 4. So I could technically break that. Damn. He's coming. Let's end turn here. So let's put that. And then he dies. Oh god, you launch. Are you a normal guy? You're a normal guy, I think. Yeah, you're a wretch. Let's grab the memory. That's a third preserved memory, by the way. Would you like to point that out? You're a rot. I don't want him blown up in my face, so we're gonna move over here. Exactly. Let's obtain a gear item. Oh, I'm full. I guess we're going to the core suffering now. Wow, look at all that stuff we just got. That was a fun room. This is a really fun room, actually. All right, is it big boy time? It's big boy time. Isn't this guy a face last time? No, it's mind. Nascent confusion within... You are other former selves, but you are the self in control for now. When will you become a former self for yourself? One day, another self will grow bigger, stronger than the self you identify with. You have discarded those altars without memory or without mercy. Do not expect any return. Growth-induced carcasses, large-scale devastation, pushy. Well, hell. Is there anything around that I need to, like... They used should. They used should. And I know why they used should, you know? Hold alt for details. What if I could push him? Let's heal. For one. Let's move. Dead self? The decomposing corpse of a former self. It might look repulsive to you, but the forsaken thoughts would kill to feed on its spiritual flesh. Oh. Oh god, it poisons. I should have known that. Ow. Can I push it? That's gonna be a no. That's why I did that, and now I could do this. Ow. All of us? Wait. Huh? Oh, the switch would have been fantastic. Oh, I didn't know about that shit. When you hit an enemy with a disable or interrupt, their cast, they become resistant to similar effects for a few turns. Oh, you can hover over characters to see a list of affected currently. Oh, okay. Can I finish them? No. 40, 80, 120. So let's heal. Wow. Okay. Oh, Jesus, did you see that? Ow. Ow. Oh. Oh, thank God. Okay. Ooh, that was close. Oh, that was so close. Oh my gosh. Choose three. I already have spike gloves now. Yeah, see, I got spike gloves in there. So I got the spike gloves there. And I got control chip. And I got a wall one. Increases shield by 9. Ooh. I'll take those three. At least these are different. No, these are the same. And I got fading memory, which gives me a crap ton of stuff. And it healed them. Reputation dumpstead. Your reputation dumpstead is now tolerated. You attract more patients. Your renown will reach more notorious patients. You'll find better items. Nice. Yeah, okay, well, some shady old guy wants a word with you. Thought you wouldn't want me to kick him out immediately. Figured a paradigm of old brain fiddlers such as yourselves shouldn't be left in this hole unattended. Welcome to Dumpstead. I'm Dealer. This place is so much warmer than it used to be. How can I help you? My mind is in the right place, so I guess that strikes most items in your menu. You have a ship, and since it came that way, it's safe to assume it's headed south. I could use a ride. Bart is in, throws in an ironic punchline too, then he asks for a lift. Sorry, I might have grown a bit cynical. Didn't mean to be insulting. I can offer my services in return. I got a knack for finding valuable data. Transposer gear, synapses, inks. Turns out deserted metropolis isn't a bad place to scavenge tech from. I'll trade you at a discount. A ride for a temporary portable shop? Yeah, okay, that's not a bad deal. I would definitely travel to shadier folks. Welcome aboard the Afterthought, Gramps. Oh, that's the name of the ship. It's called Afterthought. I love that. You've unlocked the shop, Dealer. We'll frequently show up for new goods. Nice! This is the ship right here that you can apparently upgrade as you go along, which they're not... It's not in the game yet, but this is super freaking cool. I'm glad I fell onto this game. This is a really freaking cool game. I really like it. I'm very excited to see where it goes. I hope you guys enjoyed it too. Thank you so much for joining me for the Indie Buffet, folks, where we'll help you find your next favorite indie. Peace.